Good morning. You'll notice there's a lot more kids today because Sunday school starts this week. Oh my gosh, there's so many more in the narthex coming in. It is so good to be with you all this beautiful, warm September morning. But I promise you, there is leaves changing. So fall is coming if you're a fall person. I'm sorry if you're a summer person. This is my favorite season. I'm super excited. Good to be with you all. Before we begin worship, as always, there's a lot going on. Some of us have school and Sunday school, and some have started confirmation. Some of us are still working. Some of us are coming back from travels. And so when we come on Sunday mornings, we always just like to take a moment to settle ourselves in this space, to open ourselves to hear God's word. And so we'll take a moment of silence and stillness. And we continue with our call to worship on the screen. Friends, let us worship God today, for God is great. God has blessed us with life, with faith, and with community. Let us worship God today, for God is good. God forgives us and encourages us and loves us. Let us worship God today, because we are God's people. Let us worship God together. Amen. I invite you to stand as you are comfortable for our opening song.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. God, he reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Also with you.
Thank you so much. Please be seated. And join me in the prayer of the day on our screen. Gracious God, we have come this day for your words of healing and love and hope. Give us courage and strength to be your faithful disciples. Enter our hearts and our spirits and teach us to follow your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. At this time, we have our children's sermon, so any of our littlest Lutherans can come on up. And I know there's a lot of you guys today getting ready for Sunday school, so come on up. Good morning. Good morning. I like the cat on your necklace. It looks like my cat. Good morning. How's school going for you guys? Thumbs up? Good. There's a lot more thumbs up than thumbs down, right? Good. Good morning. All right. I know you all are in school, but we have a very easy, I promise you, pop quiz this morning. I'm going to give you four clues, and I want you to tell me who I'm thinking of, all right? It's a guess who game. I'll give you four clues, and you tell me who I'm thinking of. First clue, he taught and traveled with 12 of his best friends. First clue. Second clue, he healed and fed lots and lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of people. Third clue, we sing about him and talk about him every day in church. You guys know yet? Okay, the fourth clue, we celebrate his birthday on Christmas. Do you all know who it is? Who is it? Jesus! Yeah, we're talking about Jesus today. Those are good. Those are four easy clues, but we start Sunday school for many of you today, and you're going to learn a lot more about Jesus and God and who they are and what the scriptures say. And we're going to learn through reading the Bibles. You're going to learn through praying together and through playing games and other fun things in Sunday school today, right? And I'm so excited to hear all the fun facts and different things you learn. Before you go to Sunday school today, we have a prayer. So you all show me your good prayer hands, and I'll send you on your way to Sunday school. And we do a call and response, and congregation can help us. Dear God, thank you for Jesus and time to learn in Sunday school. Bless our learning. Amen. Go have fun in Sunday school or the nursery or the prayer ground or wherever you're headed today. And congregation, we continue with our next praise song.
I would is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid, think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. Nothing will I fear.
Amen. Thanks to our new band, right? They're doing amazing. If you like their music, you should join us on Wednesday nights for worship as well. It's a lot of really fun contemporary music, and we give thanks for all of them. And now we continue with our confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, who forgives all of our sins, whose mercy endures forever. Amen. Let us confess our sin and come to God for healing. We'll take a moment for silent, prayerful reflection. Gracious God, have mercy on us. We confess that we have honored you with our lips, but have harmed our neighbors with our tongues. The cravings at war within us cause conflicts and disputes. In our desire to be first, we make distinctions among ourselves. We place the needs of the poor and the suffering last. In your great mercy, forgive our sins. Draw near to us with the grace in time of need, and turn us to follow the way of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. God promises to forgive our iniquity and to remember our sins no more. By the grace of God, you have been saved in the name of Jesus Christ, the source of eternal healing. All of our sins are forgiven. Amen. And we'll continue with hearing our readings.
Good morning. This is the first reading from Isaiah 50, verses 4 through 9a. The Lord has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning, he wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave my back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me. Therefore, I have not been disgraced. Therefore, I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me. Who will declare me guilty? This is the word of the Lord.
And our gospel reading comes from Mark, the 8th chapter. Jesus went on with his disciples to the villages of Caesarea Philippi, and on the way he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that I am?" And they answered him, "John the Baptist, and others Elijah, and still others one of the prophets." And then he asked them, "But who do you say that I am?" But Peter answered him, "You are the Messiah." And Jesus sternly ordered them to tell no one about him. Then he began to teach them that the Son of Man must undergo great suffering and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and after 3 days be rise again. And he said all this quite openly. And Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. But turning and looking at his disciples, he rebuked Peter and said, "Get behind me, Satan, for you're setting your mind not on divine things, but on human things." He called the crowd with his disciples and said to them, "If you want to become my followers, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake and for the sake of the gospel will save it. For what will it profit them to gain the whole world and forfeit their life? Indeed, what can they give in return for their life? Those who are ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of them the Son of Man will also be ashamed when he comes in glory of his Father and his holy angels." This is the gospel of our Lord. Thanks be to God. So the school has started again. Confirmation has started on this Wednesday in Shifters. The 6th and 7th grade will join us this coming Wednesday. And Sunday school starts today, and there's a buzz of energy around. And as all things, when we're beginning and coming back together as a community like this, there's always a review session, right? A recap of the last year to make sure everyone's staying on the same page and primed and ready for new information and learning. Even though I hated these school days of just review and go over the syllabus, I forgot how much I had forgotten, so it was a good way to get my intellectual muscles moving again. And so Jesus is doing the same with his disciples. He's having his own kind of review session with them. They've been teaching and traveling for so long now, and they're about to get into the thick of things. So he thought, let's stop and review. Let's check in and see where everybody is at. So like a good teacher, he just starts with an easy question to get them talking and get them going. And he says, who do others say that I am? As in, what's the gossip around town? What have you heard so far? This is an easy question. So I assume the disciples are all jumping over themselves to answer what they've heard. People say you're John the Baptist. No. They say you're more like Elijah. More people say Elijah. No, a lot of people just say you're like one of the prophets. I've heard them talking about it. They're sure you're one of the prophets. And Jesus just listens to their cacophony of answers. And he doesn't say if they're right or if they're wrong. He just lets them list these ideas, these facts that they've heard. Because really, he's just getting them ready for the bigger question, the harder question that follows. He gives them an easy place to begin. What are other people saying? In a question they can't get wrong, really, before he gets to the real heart of the matter. So after they've answered, he says, who do you say that I am? Meaning, forget about other people's theologies and interpretations. Let's put aside tradition and creed, even though they are very valuable, and let's consider this life we've lived together so far. Think about the bread we've broken together, the miles we've walked, the burdens we've carried, the tears we've shared, the laughter we've shared. Who am I to you? This question's a lot harder to answer, right? It involves some internal digging and processing, and Jesus just waits for their answer. He wants them to sit with this question for a moment, evaluate what they know, what they've experienced, how they felt, what they've witnessed Jesus do. What is this relationship to you? Jesus is asking them. And finally, the ever so confident Peter always steps up first and says, you are the Messiah. Meaning Jesus is the one that they have been waiting for, the one that would lead them to liberation, the one God sent for the people to save them all. A plus, Peter, that is the correct answer, and you got it, at least in this moment. He always gets it wrong a little bit later, right? So Jesus, now that the prime has been pumped and they're ready, he's entering the hardest part of the lesson for them. There are consequences for Jesus being the Messiah he's trying to teach them. Jesus came to change the world in a really big way, to feed the hungry, heal the sick, bring dignity to the poor, forgive all of those experiencing shame and regret. He kept company with the least popular people, and in doing so, he was bringing all these people together, and they were turning their focus toward him. His actions were contrary to the Roman Empire at the time. Jesus' words and deeds of love and peace and freedom were so refreshing to those experiencing suffering that they were choosing to follow him. And this is what got Jesus killed, right? Because the people in power at the time, King Caesar, was threatened by Jesus' divine way of leading, a way of love and freedom and peace over control and oppression. Jesus was pulling people to him, and it would lead to his death. And this scared Peter. Of course it scared Peter. He loved Jesus. He didn't want to see Jesus suffer. He wanted Jesus to have all of the glory and none of the sacrifice. But Jesus needed them to know this was part of who Jesus was. He needed to live and heal and feed and teach and then die and rise again on the third day. And he needed Peter and the disciples to be ready for what they were about to witness firsthand. He wanted them to know that there was glory in being the Messiah, and there would be sacrifice, and somehow it would be okay with God. Peter would later become known as the rock on which the church was started, a leader to his fellow disciples and many other followers of Jesus. He got it right a lot. but he also got this following Jesus wrong too, right? He was human. He would have the courage to walk on water towards Jesus, but then panic and start to sink. He would follow Jesus to the last day when Jesus was on the cross, but also deny him publicly. But all through all of this, in his heart of hearts, he knew that Jesus was the Messiah and he would always follow him. And that was what Jesus needed him to know at the end of the day, and he would forgive all of the rest. Throughout this fall, in our worship, we'll hear many different stories of Jesus' ministry and a lot of his preaching and teaching to his disciples. And some of these stories we've known forever, and they're easy to digest. And some of them are kind of hard and have a lot to really dig into, and they're harder to hear. But we start here at this core question, who is Jesus to you? We start here so we have some footing as we grow and learn throughout this fall. Maybe your answer to who is Jesus to you is an easy answer. Maybe it comes to you quickly, like Peter. Maybe you've only been taught the creeds and that's all you know how to say about who Jesus is. And you haven't thought about what is my personal relationship with Jesus yet. Maybe you don't even know where to begin with this question, and wherever you're at, that's okay. We're exploring and learning together. This question that Jesus poses to us, who is Jesus to you, is meant to be an invitation asked in love to help you explore your faith, to encourage you to dive into the scriptures and Bible studies we offer here at Joy, to maybe give you a guiding question for your meditations and prayers. It is not a pop quiz. It is not something designed to trip you up and make you fail. It is an invitation to exploration of your faith in who is Jesus to you. And it takes time and patience, and we'll go through these questions together. So this fall, as school and confirmation and Bible studies and Sunday school start up, let this question be for you all, too, a new exploration of your faith, a new beginning in your faith. Jesus invites you to come and learn and listen and grow in love. Amen. I invite you to stand as you are comfortable for our next song.
Thank you.
Please be seated. Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us profess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, the Holy Spirit received by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. And the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Drawn together into the power of the Holy Spirit, we pray with confidence for the church, God's good creation, and all those who are in need. We pray for the church throughout the world. Form us into communities of forgiveness and grace. Help us to notice where you are calling us into new relationships, and give us courage to embrace the uncomfortable and the unfamiliar. God of grace, receive our prayer. We pray for the earth and all its inhabitants. Protect lands at risk of wildfire and heal dying forests. Where fire brings destruction, raise up new growth. Guide us in tending precarious ecosystems. God of grace, receive our prayer. We pray for those who govern nations, tribes, and cities. Open them to the cries of the people in need. Direct them in shaping policies that prioritize health and well-being of all who struggle with hunger and housing insecurity. God of grace, receive our prayer. We pray for all who are ill, all who are lonely or anxious, and all who grieve, especially those we name aloud in our hearts or silently in this space. Draw them close to you, O Lord, and soothe them with the promise of your enduring love. God of grace, receive our prayer. We pray for our teachers, professors, librarians, school administrators, staff, janitors, and all who support the education of young people. Sustain them as they shape learning in our community, rooted in equity and authenticity. We pray for our children of all ages in their learning. God of grace, receive our prayer. We remember our beloved dead who, with a great cloud of witness, bear witness to your saving grace. Accompany us in our pilgrimage of faith that we, too, place our hope and our trust in you. God of grace, receive our prayer. We entrust these and all our prayers to you, Holy God, in the name of your beloved child, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. And together we say, Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always. Thank you so much. Please share a sign of peace with those that are around you. As we return to our seats as well, remember this is your time. You can send a text in church to anyone that needs a little extra peace or someone who you might want to visit after church too and bring some love and grace of God to them. And we'll continue with receiving our offering. And let us pray over our offering. Blessed are you, O God, source of every gift of your creation. By these gifts and with our lives, help us to serve one another and all in need. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. To sustain Jesus' disciples and all of his followers, to make sure they could continue to explore and learn about who Jesus was, he fed them, and he fed them with his very life, a sacrifice of love for all of them. On the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Taste and see that God is good. All are welcome to come forward and receive communion. And we'll take communion servers first. Now that we all have been fed, receive this blessing. May the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his peace. Amen. And let us pray. Holy God, you have welcomed us to this meal and fed us with dignity at your table. Send us now to welcome others and to be at peace with one another. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Now it is time for everyone's favorite part of the service, some announcements. But we always start with a fun one. I had two little birdies tell me that tomorrow is Lisa Olson's birthday. She was the one that read and greeted too, so on her birthday we got her working. So we have to say happy birthday to Lisa. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Woo! Happy birthday, dear Lisa. Happy birthday to you. Woo! I know she said, "Who's the second one?" I'll let you can figure it out. It's perfect. We love singing happy birthday and anniversary. If you haven't heard us do this tradition yet, you just have to let me know before service starts or sometime in the week, and I'll fill it out in my calendar. So let me know. And we'll continue with some announcements. Leah's my clicker. The ladies' luncheon is next Sunday from 1 to 3, and Carmen is going to be the one making an announcement about it for us.
Good morning. Okay, like Pastor Melissa said, our ladies' luncheon is next Sunday, the 22nd, from 1 until 3. The cost is $5 per person, and all of the funds that we raise will be going to camperships for our youth of the congregation. If you don't know, Jay Welka pays 50% of their camperships. And this last summer, we had about 8 youth from our congregation attend Luther Park Bible Camp, and some of them went twice. So just wanted to mention that. And then also maybe wanted to share a little bit of a story of myself as to why going to Bible Camp is such a great idea for our youth. I went to Bible camp. It was kind of a requirement for confirmation. And my mom is here, and she will tell you that when I left, I cried so hard because it was the first time in my life where I had gone outside of my safe space, my home, my church, my family, where I felt like I belonged. I felt accepted. I felt like I was just like every other kid. So just to tug on your heartstrings a little bit, that's why I feel Bible camp is so important. So again, next Sunday, $5 per person, 1 to 3 p.m. You can pay by check, cash, or you can pay by credit card. We prefer check or cash. And you can pay with the credit card at one of our kiosks outside in the narthex. And you can get tickets from David in the office. You can get them from me today after church. Or if you're not sure of your schedule, you can show up on Sunday and you can get your ticket at the door. The last thing I wanted to say is that if you cannot attend, we are accepting donations, again, for camperships. So everything that we raise is going back to our camperships. And we hope to see you and invite a friend. And then one more thing, we have this little lantern. If you want to make a donation, you can put it in here. And Kelly pointed out as I came out, this is like a lantern, so we want our youth to go out and be a light to the world. So, thank you.
That's beautiful. We're so excited for the ladies' luncheon. If you saw the table in the narthex, all of the tables will be decorated in some sort of theme, and there'll be a little table decorating competition. You don't have to decorate a table to come, just come. We already have table decorators signed up, but it'll be a really great time. Next we have today is our magic show right after worship in the fellowship hall. It's an all ages magic show. Everybody loves wonder, everybody loves fun. So come on and join us in the fellowship hall. If you would like a quieter space to chat though, feel free to use the foosball room or the library as well. And as you see, Sunday school started and all the kids came back. Wednesday worship has started up again. It's every Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. with our Joyful Noise Band, which you hear today. We're also trying new ways of praying, like different contemporary ways, contemplative ways of praying together, and a lot of really fun contemporary music. So it'll be a really great, it's only about a 30-minute worship, and there is communion. This Wednesday for meals, I always have to look behind me, is stroganoff, and next week is spaghetti. So come join us Wednesdays. They're free meals, 5:15 to 6:30. And we are still looking for feedback. If you have any feedback on worships and stuff, there's a feedback form back by the crosses on your left-hand side as you exit. Just write down what date you came in. Joyful Quilters are running again. You all know about that one. Help spread the word about joy. You all know about that one, too. Handbells practices started on Mondays at 6 p.m. There's still time to join. You can talk to Joan Northouse if you are interested. Sharing and Caring Hands is this week if you all know what you signed up for already. And finally, before we go on our way, a blessing. May the words of our mouths be acceptable and true. May the meditations of our hearts be loving and pure. May the actions of our lives be grace-filled and kind. May we go in Christ where Christ leads and journey in God's truth. Amen. I invite you to stand as you are comfortable for our sending song.
Forever, and all is good, and above all things.
Go in peace, serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.